从前有座山，山里头有座庙，庙里有个老和尚讲故事。他讲的是什么呢？功夫是个啥？传说有绝学，深山藏秘籍，觅得于神兵，逍遥闯江湖，仗义行天下。
Like dew, like lightning, fast and powerful. A language that doesn't need translation is Kung Fu. To cultivate oneself, regulate one's family, to govern the nation and unite the world, that's the supreme pursuit of the Chinese people. To spread, to experience, to collide, to communicate, and to merge. That's the mission of Shaolin Kung Fu masters in this new age. All Kung Fu originated from the Shaolin Temple, and Shaolin Kung Fu is now seen in every corner of the world. Is a romantic city. There's a legendary man who practices Shaolin Kung Fu beside the Seine. People often catch a glimpse of a figure swiftly passing by. Dominique Sa Tinang is the African Bruce Lee. His way of doing physical exercises is very unique. He started learning Shaolin Kung Fu in China at the age of 20 and studied there for 10 years.
2011年，这个大的机会给我，让我做少林文化大使。我就想做一个事情，传播少林文化。除了我练，也让更多的人会认识那个中国武术。
Shaolin monk is another identity for this Frenchman of African descent.
I am in Africa, every country I know. Europe also knows, America also knows my martial arts. Because any place needs martial arts,我会的时候，我就把教到他们了。
Relying on his excellent Shaolin Kung Fu, Dominique participates in all kinds of activities and performances around the world, and has become a Kung Fu star, followed by many fans. In his spare time, he also teaches Shaolin Kung Fu in Paris.
武术就是慢慢练，慢慢学。所以，因为武术帮助我的身体好，每天练让我的身体好。教人那个少林的文化是什么，武术是什么，中国的文化是什么，就是可以把让大家都了解那个中国文化。
An inch of land in the Champs-Élysées is worth an inch of gold.Dominique has rented an office here to promote Shaolin Kung Fu. To him, only a world-class top-level community can match authentic Shaolin Kung Fu.
现在在喀麦隆、马里、克里瓦、比尼，在那个大鹏，还有那个康果，我都那边都有学生。我现在就是想做很大，我希望更多外国人也会了解那个中国文化，让更多的人会。
To the Chinese, he's a foreigner who practices Kung Fu. But to foreigners, he's the African Bruce Lee.
李小龙是我的目标，当时我没想到他们会成我那个非洲李小龙。 对应气功很感兴趣，所以我特别喜欢开弓呢、开钢牌，这个不中的人会不会？如果你练，你肯定那个会受伤了。这个是正规的少林的武术，没有别的地方能学到那个应气功。我的学生们问他们，他们说他们想以后跟我一样的，如果。
After becoming a kung fu star, Dominique started to act in films.
Wushu 电影就看就是中国人。 我也想让大家知道这个武术的电影，不是就是一个中国人能拍。我希望我会有那个机会，也拍一个好的电影，跟那个成龙、李连杰都一样的。因为我也在少林寺学武术那个这么长时间。
In this movie, which has entered its post-production phase, Dominique has only about 2 minutes to show off his kung fu skills. So he isn't that satisfied. He hopes that one day he can play a leading role in a real kung fu movie.
So I hope that foreigners can see my films and are interested in Chinese martial arts.
'Today, Dominique will pick out several outstanding students from among his apprentices and take them to the Shaolin Temple, where he learned genuine Shaolin Kung Fu. Dominique was the first African disciple officially accepted by the Shaolin Temple. As a Shaolin monk returning to the temple, he has to put on a robe, burn incense, and show respect to Buddha. In the 1,000 Buddha Hall, there are 48 pits left by generations of Shaolin monks. Dominique and his apprentices feel and experience authentic Shaolin Kung Fu that combines Zen Buddhism with martial arts. According to the ancient rules, practicing Shaolin Kung Fu requires one to be down to Shaolin's earth. In the following 2 months, Dominique will take his apprentices to practice Shaolin Kung Fu deep inside Mount Song. At the moment, at the starting point of Shaolin Kung Fu, Dominique shares the honor, but also shoulders the responsibility to make Shaolin Kung Fu known to the world. The United Kingdom is one of the world's oldest industrial powers and values scientific proofs and pursues practical results. Kung Fu is no exception. Winning or losing is the only standard that British people use to judge whether you have what it takes. Shaolin Kung Fu has drawn plenty of attention thanks to Kung Fu movies, but here it was once looked down upon.
刚开始在咱们跟他们搞交流的时候，他们都是很瞧不起，他们一听是中国功夫，他们就笑，他们就摆出一些什么猴的动作呀、鹤形动作呀、虎拳呢，就是当玩笑说，他们会这些东西，但是根本就经不起打。那我带着人去了之后，不但没有把我拳打败呀，我们把他们打败呀。这样久而久之的话呢，在这边来算是站得住脚。
Relying on Shaolin Kung Fu, Shi Yanlei challenged almost all of London's big and small fight clubs. After 3 years of effort, Shaolin Kung Fu finally found its own place in London. Nowadays, many European young people come to London and learn Shaolin Kung Fu from Shi Yanlei.
I sort out the first. And I block this. I just don't let them come out. Can you see? Do 1, 2? Huh? Can you see? Huh? 1, see that? 1. Huh? 1. This one just like.
Shi Yanlei, Shi Yanzi's younger brother, has helped Shi Yanzi lay the foundation of Shaolin Kung Fu in London. But he has totally different ideas from his brother about the way to spread Shaolin Kung Fu.
当时他们建这个英国少林寺的时候，我是用严子把我弄过来，我是帮他建的。我不是很喜欢这种职业的教练工作，因为我没有选择别人的权利。师傅严子他想的东西和我想的东西不一样，走的路也不同。他是一种，比如说他买一个桌子在那里，他就觉得哦，这个桌子在这里，他就很。 放心，实体的东西，我虽然这个中国功夫，我就要一个拳馆，在我的拳馆培养育人，这是他的方法。我认为呢，网络是一种最好的宣传手段，它非常快捷。这个网上的东西我弄了差不多7、8年了吧，现在有60多万吧，都是我的粉丝，把我自己的训练的视频放上去，放一些我觉得对我的这个粉丝有帮助的东西，从网上他就可以直接获得，他不用。
But for his brother, Shi Yanlei, to touch the blue sky of Kung Fu, he needs to teach people in person, both physically and mentally.
有一批人不是冲着实战功夫来的，他是冲着身体来的。这个在西方还比较多，但是作为我们文化传承者，这个不是最真正的目的。 我们真正的目的是要把我们少林的精神，还有少林的文化，传承到英国本土人。他们是传人，下一代，他们接这个班，他们能够把它一代一代传下去。A
King is one of the 20 British native coaches Shi Yanlei is training.
Yeah, because it's kind of moved away from what they have, because they had like. Weird things like
A King is an animation designer. At the moment, he has to finish his work and hurry to the Shaolin Temple, UK, as soon as possible. There will be an important examination in the afternoon.
你要练武就别怕苦。所以说我教学也比较严格，然后呢我亲自跟他们做示范，跟他们一起练。我说我现在告诉你们，你们来学功夫，我让你练什么你练什么，你必须按照我的方法，别过了这一关才能进第二关，你过了第二关才能进第三关。
Overseas, Chinese Kung Fu only exists in films. This led Shi Yanlei to conclude that making Kung Fu movies are the best way to spread Kung Fu.
因为我本身呢对电影呢也有兴趣，拍功夫电影 action film， 他们都用的是一些明星，他们根本就不懂功夫，真正能打的反而没有成为明星。我作为一个舞者，我们这么辛苦练，我们给别人当替身，凭什么？为什么？我自己要拍电影，我自己要用懂武行的人去拍电影，我宁可倾家荡产，我也把它拍出来。
In 2012, Shi Yanlei made a real kung fu movie with money he'd raised. His intention with the film is to inform the world that Shaolin Kung Fu.Is a powerful martial art.
Yes, sir.
Today, the two brothers will fight each other with different martial arts skills. They plan to learn from each other's strong points to raise the level of combat.
怎么样把那传统东西不能够在实战中更好的用？
他一挡他就这样打，他不管怎么样他这样打他还是慢一拍。然后你打过再打别人过来，你看。看到没有，我这挡了之后，他是挡了再挡，我是挡的同时就打了，挡到的时候就打到了。你看，像那个少林里面的东西，双龙出洞是吧？他就是这样打的，啊，是吧？
弄死了。
好，
啊，
你别说，
我有一个罩子，
他让风进来了。
他就是跟那个一样，我这个动作的身
我说的意思，我就是通过这个动作把它改变成这样一个现在的动作，就拿起来。我让你说我出腿，看你疯了吧？我真的，我就打了，你再疯我就打了，我不让你疯了。
我可以听他打，往前打。你
还手。
这个东西是你的。是吧？
刚才你弄那个，我都弄不出来，是吧？这个我弄，你也弄不出
来。我只想干我自己想干的事情。如果我以后成为明星了，那我也只能告诉别人，我只是做了我自己想干的事情，不是我选择的你，是明星选择了我。
Shi Yanzi still insists on teaching apprentices in his fight club, while Shi Yanlei uses media to spread interest in kung fu.
One step at a time, we must develop such kind of talent. When you have such real people who can stand up and prove themselves, the traditional martial arts will have hope.
A few days later,A King passes the examination and becomes a professional coach. Now, like envoys, the foreign apprentices of Shi Yanzi are teaching Shaolin Kung Fu to more and more people who love Chinese Kung Fu. Lin Shengjie, the first Taiwanese Shaolin apprentice, began to learn Kung Fu at the Shaolin Temple 10 years ago.
我还记得我到少林寺第一天的那个画面，我站在少林寺的钟楼底下，一阵风吹来，我听到那个钟声在响的时候，我突然感觉到，哇，原来这就是传说中的少林寺。
Taiwan faces the Chinese mainland across the sea. As a Chinese man, Lin Shengjie thinks that Shaolin Kung Fu is an indispensable cultural element in Taiwan.
久而久之，你就会发现，其实少林功夫它很容易融入在地的环境，所以我那时候慢慢练功，其实还是有一些人看到。Lin
Shengjie earnestly practices and advocates 8-section brocade in the name of keeping fit.
回来第一年，跟我学功夫的人可能不会超过10个。 不管学生人数多还是少，我都尽我的所能，去让他们了解，而且让他们避免在学习的过程中受到伤害，比如说运动伤害啊，或者是他们今天因为不懂，然后而造成就是自己或别人的伤害。Currently,
there are more than 200 people in Taiwan learning Shaolin Kung Fu from Lin. In 2006, he established the Taiwan Buddhist Shaolin Kung Fu Group. After training, Lin visits the night market with his fellow members. Here, they're not only master and apprentice, but also friends. Every week, the group members gather in Taipei from all parts of Taiwan at a fixed time. They practice 8-section brocade with Lin Shengjie.
In the Shaolin功法里面，它有一套属于就是内功的八段锦，它只有很简单的8个动作到12个动作。 我开始呢，把它更简化，然后更清楚地呈现在台湾的这些群众面前，然后让他们用很简单，而且不需要花太多时间的方式，它就可以达到让身体健身的效果。少林寺1500年累积的这个武功的功法，把它融入到一般的养生功法八段锦里面，它可以把你的能量输送到你的末端。好，所以这是我们跟别人不一样的地方。我昨天用我的内力。 精炖了一锅薏仁汤，给大家美白，本人的一点小小的心意，好，所以喜欢不喜欢都来上一碗再走吧。
可以，拿这个碗了吗？
来，神宇，来，谢谢。
因为我大学念的是餐饮管理跟食品营养，那我也会帮助学生身体变得健康一点，我会帮他们调整他们的餐食的比例，同时也是让大家在练功之余可以透过这种食补的方式来养生。那我把这个概念结合练功，其实我发现这样子的推广方式很快，所以就从这样子慢慢的一个两个，然后慢慢的再慢慢变多，我们就从一个很小很小的班，然后累积成现在一个很大的功课。
一二三，西瓜甜点。
In Lin Shengjie's eyes, learning Kung Fu in the Shaolin Temple and spreading Kung Fu to Taiwan is a way of cultivating himself.
给我最大的盲点就是我不再有师兄弟，还有不再有师父在我身边指导我练功，我还能再继续进步吗？我曾经为此感到茫然，后来我慢慢的去了解到这套拳、这套剑或者是这套功夫，它其实会在不同的年纪有不同的体验，只要我用心去感受，其实师父就在我的心中。
For more than a century, there's been a connection between Germany and China. After Shaolin Kung Fu began to sow its seeds all around the world, Germany was the first country to bear fruit. In 2001, the first global communication center of Shaolin culture was constructed in Berlin. Interestingly, Shi Yanlei, the first Shaolin monk to arrive here,knew nothing about Kung Fu. Although the communication center was ready to welcome its German guests, the ensuing problems went far beyond Shi Yanlei's expectations.
刚开始呢，德国人认为我们都是外星球的人，哦，舍利和尚，从来没有听说过，没有见过，一个学生都没有。
Not many Germans have heard of the Shaolin Temple, though many know of Chinese Kung Fu. So Shi Yanlei invited some Shaolin monks to Berlin. He felt Shaolin Kung Fu might be the seed.For Shaolin culture to take root in Germany.
年轻人，15岁到30岁之间的喜欢少林功夫，视角很好，又蹦又跳，看起来就像飞人一样。他们想接触气功，接触太极，接触少林功夫，然后呢，慢慢的一点一点的把这个线路给他们铺好，起到一个抛砖引玉的作用。
Leo has been learning Shaolin Kung Fu in the communication center since he was 9 years old. As a Kung Fu movie fan, he admires Jackie Chan and Jet Li the most.
成龙的电影我几乎都看了，李连杰的电影我也看了不少，李小龙的也有一些。我喜欢这些电影，我觉得学功夫特别好，可以激发出力量，保护自己，所以我就去学功夫了。
In 9 years, Leo has grown into a fine young man, and the influence Kung Fu has had on him is evident.
我是从2007年开始练功夫的，将近9年了。期间我经常受伤，有一次连学都上不了了。我看过很多电影激励我坚持下来，功夫已经成了我生活的一部分。
Like many young German men, Leo loves rap, but he's also proud of his Shaolin Kung Fu.
My 的朋友都知道我喜欢学功夫，我偶尔会露两手，他们都很羡慕我。我自己很喜欢这种状态。去年10月份，我去了少林寺，进行了很多训练，虽然很苦，但却是我想要的。
During the summer before college, Leo didn't travel with his classmates. Instead, he chose to spend even more time practicing Kung Fu.
我先学到的是阴阳理论，这可以说功夫给我带来了很大的收获。换句话说，我知道总是有好有坏，总是保持一种平衡，这就是对我日常生活的帮助。
It's been 26 years since the Berlin Wall was raised, but the German people still live in the shadow of political confrontation and the repercussions of the Cold War. Against this background, Shi Yanlei arrived with Shaolin Zen Buddhism. Kung Fu strengthens one's body, while Zen Buddhism cultivates one's spirit. It has opened a window for Germans to learn more about Chinese culture.
年轻人喜欢少林功夫，但是知识阶层的社会精英，他们还是对中国的佛教文化、禅宗的哲学更感兴趣。我们开的课程有禅宗打坐课、佛法讲座课，但是是很难的。经文对中国人来说都非常难懂，也说把它再翻译成德语，让德国人来接受。从我来德国的第一天，我就开始学德语。
Gemeinschaftsgeist besitzen, Jugend der Sinn, den Dingen auf den Grund gehen, trüben Sorgen.
Translating the classics of Zen has taken Shi Yanlei considerable time. Another big problem for him in Germany is food. Every Friday, he goes to an Asian supermarket 8 kilometers away to buy Chinese food.
Shanghai 阳春面，看起来倒是不错。花生酱，花生酱，夏天吃凉面可以。当然要是有一个适应的阶段，我大概是差不多3年的时间，我的肠胃一直有问题。
Their daily food is very simple. Even in a faraway foreign country, they still stick to an austere life.
有勇气，不屈不挠。佛教有句话叫难行能行，越是难走的地方你要走过去，这才证明你的能力。
This weekend, Zhe Yongchuan drives to a friend's home.
德国学生，他呢现在呢有个儿子，也非常喜欢踢足球，所以今天呢我们去他家呢，聊聊天，然后呢跟他儿子一块踢踢足球。Hallo Stina.
Hallo.
Grüß dich. Ja, schau mal bitte.
Ah, danke schön.
Hier mal. Grüne Tee.
Danke schön.
Ja, wieder, wieder. Gerne. Du bist der Chef.
Nein.
Ja, zum Wohl, Markus.
Und morgen ein neuer Trainingsplan?
Nächste Woche. Morgen in Yanyo. Fliegen nach München für 3 Tage Seminar.
Ja.
Nummer 12, Paul. Hey, du bist der. 他的名字叫 Paul. 他这个球衣呢，selber ist der.
Beim richtigen Spiel hat er. Welche Nummer hast du beim richtigen Spiel?
5.
Nummer 5.
他这个踢足球在墙上的位置是5号。Links X, 他是左右都可以踢，左右边锋。他属于这种，这中场这个边锋的队员。
Shi Yanlei is happy that he's able to visit German families and become friends with local people. He's pleased that the Shaolin culture is being accepted by more and more German people. After 15 years' effort, the situation of Shaolin culture in Germany has greatly improved.
2年以后，德国报纸、德国电视台报道说呢，少林文化就像一个窗户，打开了德国人的心扉，让德国人吸收到了新鲜的空气和养分。
Through Shaolin Kung Fu, Chinese culture is making its way to the broader world. Budapest, Hungary. The Danube bisects the city. Wang Deqing has been living in this beautiful place for 16 years. Over the past 16 years, he's earned quite a reputation for his Shaolin Kung Fu.
少林寺学功夫，这是最早一批外派的武生之一。当时外派到欧洲的时候，我发现欧洲的人到少林寺去学习功夫时间都不是很长，但是呢，他们回来以后呢，都是剃了一个光头，穿了一个生衣，喝个酒啊，搂个女孩呀，说他是从少林寺出来，在当地就开始张扬地宣传他自己。看到这个情况的时候，我就说我要让西方人知道少林功夫它的内涵，禅宗的思想和武功的真正的含义在哪里，把中国文化都能在欧洲发扬光大。
It took Wang Deqing 10 years to go from being a kung fu coach in a small club in Budapest to the head coach of the Hungarian Presidential Protective Escorts. It was a major turn in his life.
In 2002, I joined the Shaolin Police Police Force as a teacher. In the police force police force, there are kung fu and tai quan, but the only thing is there is no kung fu. They个子高，力气也大，也小小的。当然，他们对你还是有很多疑问的。
1、2、3、4。
从我个人的经验呢，我抓对方的空子，他起腿我起腿，我起腿速度比较快，我会堵住他，啊，他起手我起手，我起手的方法会比他快，借他的力，使他们在瞬间看到我们的力量和速度在哪里。
After Wang Deqing entered Hungarian police circles, his life began to take another major turn.
10年后，2012年，内政部就批下来，雄中警务交流协会正式成立，就更好的去跟中国警察做交流了。其中有一个呢是射击，包括手枪、冲锋枪，最重要的是狙击枪。
Since 2008, Wang Deqing has invited the world's best sniper coaches to China more than 10 times to train China's special police and armed police. This has greatly improved China's anti-terrorism capability. Today, the Chinese special police are preparing for the 14th Police and Military Sniper World Cup.
Okay. Stand by. Start.
At the same time, Wang Deqing is still trying his best to teach Shaolin Kung Fu in Hungary. The times are changing rapidly. Shaolin Kung Fu is taking China to the world and also bringing the world closer to China.
借用在警务这个关系上，认识很多的政治家也好，企业家也好，我跟他们阐述的都是禅武，是我在警务上的工作才帮助带动禅武的发展。
Bearing Zen Buddhism in mind, Wang Deqing strictly follows the Shaolin rules.
想传播这个文化，那首先第一个就得让他认知这个礼数礼节，怎么去规范它。老祖宗们设立了这样的规矩，那他一定是很需要的。比如说合十，它象征着把你的精神和心灵和身体通过手心合十在其中，集中精神，然后向对方进行问候。
到，师傅，
李立康，
大家好。
那我们的抱拳礼呢，拳头是力量，掌是智慧，合到一起，往前再推一点，就是尊敬你，向你请教智慧和力量。
哟，没事，各位该注意是明天给巧克麦杰克马舍海也王，巧佛格罗罗的，这几天有哪里是功夫还在是王？没事，明天给艾灸海也王。也是没进来，我当白费有些地方一趟也是马上的手把包，也是没个给几基本功，嗯，等功夫拳。
有多少多少多少弟子，这个是数字，没有一点点意义。真正的我希望的是，他们在触摸禅武的这两个字的时候。去更深的了解中华文化，更深的去了解东方的智慧是什么。
On the morning of June 21st, 2015, the 14th Police and Military Sniper World Cup officially begins in Budapest, Hungary. Wang Deqing arrives at the site early in the morning. His years of effort will be tested today. At 9 o'clock, 130 contestants from 16 countries pull their triggers. After 3 days of fierce competition, the results are published. In the evening, the awards ceremony is held at the Hungary National Special Police Training Base. The Chinese delegation has won many awards. In the military section, China wins all three medals. To spread Chinese culture has become the focus of today's overseas Chinese Kung Fu practitioners. Blood is flowing, and the dream is still hot. Throughout life, everyone is longing for consummate skills, pursuing secrets, forging weapons, exploring Jianghu, and hugging the world. One's life is limited, but the heart knows no boundaries. Kung Fu is about constantly changing oneself and surpassing oneself. Kung Fu offers cultivation for every single one of us.